Welcome everybody to this week's Hangout. Sorry for the short delay. We had to set up the stream and I can welcome all the guys in the Hangout on Google and as well as the guys that listen and view us on ustream.tv. This Hangout will be a little bit different than the Hangouts before because we have a very special guest, Marco Biondi from Apps. Oh my God, appsfuel.com, and he'll gonna talk very much about how it's like to use Agile Toolkit in your own enterprise. And maybe you can give us a little bit of an introduction. Who are you? What are you doing? And what is appsfuel.com, the company you're working for, all about?
Yep. Thank you, Armin. Thank you, Roman, for inviting me to this Hangout. My name is Marco Biondi, and I'm working in Buongiorno. It's an Italian company present worldwide that gives many different entertaining services in different countries and in different areas. AppsFuel is a project that is started 1 year ago, and it's a new marketplace for HTML5 web application, an open platform easy to use for the distribution of HTML5 web application. With AppsFuel, the developers can easily reach their customers and also have many different ways to and possibility to monetize their application because of our direct billing contact with many phone operators all around the world. So we are giving this power of fire in reaching users and also giving means of monetizing the application. This is the AppsFuel project. I'm the software architect of this product, and well, Buongiorno, it's a quite a big company. It's born around the 95 and was grown quite fast during the year, and in the last month was acquired by NTT Docomo, that is the biggest phone company in Japan, so we are one of their European partner, and now we have a complete a huge amount of user. Actually we have 100 million of customers, I think, all around the world. Okay, I think it's enough for the introduction.
Okay, so in other words, what appsfuel.com does is a bit similar like the App Store of Apple would do, like giving developers the opportunity to share their applications with all the world, and they have easy access to like billing, like are you getting money out of the sales of those apps? Is that correct?
Yeah, is that correct? The marketplace is quite similar in concept as in a native App Store. Then we also have this the billing option that it's quite hard to reach for a individual developer, and also we have in plan to give other tools that helps HTML5 developer to make better applications. But we start with the market.
Yeah, talking about tools, how did you came across the Agile Toolkit? And why have you decided to try Agile Toolkit?
The thing at the beginning, we wasn't a so big team when we started to plan about this project, because it was a quite innovative idea. We have also a lot of legacy technology here in our company, and also big projects that are using those frameworks. I created in part one of them, for example. And by approaching UpsFuel, we have seen that we need a part that could be easily used by all the developers to interact with the system and manipulate the things quite easily and in a 2.0 fashion. So we look at around for a tool that could help to reach this goal with the least possible effort, because our internal frameworks were really targeted to delivering content and not to deal with interface of applications. So I started to search on the web for a week, and I evaluated a lot of PHP frameworks all around, and luckily I found out the mention to Agile Toolkit that wasn't so known at, 1 year ago. But when I looked at him, I looked at the idea and the philosophy behind, I was quite impressed, because it was exactly what we need for our task, because it's quite unique on PHP side, but even on other server-side language, to have a framework that is oriented to building interface and to have on a web application a single point of control of all the interaction, the part that is happening in the browser and even the part that is happening on the server.
Okay.
So I choose it, and I started to work on the prototype of the project on it.
So had you got any other team members you had to convince using it, and how did they react on your choice of Agile Toolkit?
Well, my direct boss was completely confident on me, because I was a senior technical, the only senior technical inside the prototyping team. Yeah, I posed to him the benefit of this choice and also the worst part at that time, because it was quite young and the documentation was not so extends as is now, and he don't pose me any trouble. Then I have to, after making the part of the prototype, I've got some people to convince that was the head of the technology of the company, that of course want to know why we want to use a new framework.
Yeah.
And
what did they say?
At the beginning, he started to, without looking at the framework itself, started to compile a list of all the question of what could be wrong, if all the pitfall that I must look for adopting it. I think I answered to all the question, and then I simply told him to, I give to him the documentation and some samples, and I waited for some question on the topics, yeah, of the real topics on the framework.
Yeah.
And he asked other guys, and a couple of them with enough seniority had, by looking at the framework, the same good impression that I've got. So he went convinced that if different people had the same good appreciation for this tool to implement good interface or complex interface that are distributed through web, it could be, it's a good tool. So he agreed to use it, and then we started to use it really deeply during the passage from the prototype to the final version of the product that now it's also public.
What features did you find most useful for your software development?
Well, surely one of them is the complete integration of the interface in one point, as I said before. It's not so easy in with some other framework. You have to build your MVC class layout for the server side. Then you have to restart from scratch when you are designing things inside the browser with the JavaScript libraries or components. The fact that with the toolkit everything is integrated in one layer, I think it's the most useful thing if you want to have a modern interface and you want to prototype it quite quickly. And also another thing that it's really appreciated by me and then by the other developers that had started to work on it is the style of code writing. You write really compact code that is quite readable, and it's really important when you have to look at a code that is made by someone else and understand what he's doing.
Sure. And how do you find philosophy and support structure of Agile Toolkit to fit in your internal practice of developing?
Well, the philosophy at the beginning, the Agile philosophy wasn't used completely in the company. We used it in a natural way, but not canonical in our development group. Then one of the main product leader proposed us to use Scrum, and of course Agile Toolkit and philosophy of Agile Toolkit really fit good with Agile development, and so we completely integrated these things on our working model.
How did you like train your developers to use Agile Toolkit? How did you approach that?
Well, at the moment we are doing it by introducing them to the toolkit with the really brand new documentation, the small manual that is on the main site, because I can use it as a basis to show the concept of the framework with the samples that are online. And then at the same time I introduce them to the architecture of our system that is quite complex. Then I'll give to all the developer all the materials that Romans has produced, even the videos, the hangout, and all the link to the documentation, and I let them have a little play around the toolkit. And I'm seeing that everyone is quite happy to do it, because when they start to enter in the philosophy of the framework, it's quite easy to test it, to modify the samples, and to produce something with the thing.
And down the road, do you think your code structure improved, or how did it affect the speed of development overall?
Well, surely comparing to our internal framework approach, the part of the code that we wrote with Agile Toolkit are wrote a little bit fast, especially when you have to deal with a complex interaction that can't be completely designed in advance. That was one of the most important goals that we have almost reached, because not only the developer must adopt the this different approach, but also is the user interface designer and the user interaction designer that must to change the mind and start to interact in a different way. We successfully tested this complete agile way of development on part of the product in the last weeks, and I think that this first result is really good, and we'll continue to apply and to get the philosophy of progressive enhancement that Agile Toolkit and Agile techniques in general are giving us to in the developing a complex application.
Marco, a quick question for you. How many developers do you have right now who is working with the toolkit?
How many developers? As you know, I'm started alone. Now we are 10 people.
That's awesome. And another question from Gourav. He was asking, what are the complicated things they find in Agile? Is anything really difficult to understand? What's the most difficult part to understand about the toolkit?
Well, it depends from the experience of everyone. I think that for me, at the beginning, it's to correctly understand the class interaction of the toolkit itself. Because if something is missing in the documentation, I have to sneak peek inside the code. And so to understand how is which guideline the project has it inside. But wasn't so difficult for me, but I started to program when I have 12 years now. I'm 40, so I think I have a quite big experience on my shoulders. By looking at my colleagues, understanding well how powerful is the model, especially if you want to build the really complex queries that involve different tables and joins, or how you have to do a good class modelation, a good class modeling in choosing if you have to subclass the data or compose them. There are the tricky part that need to be well understood. Because the philosophy it's easy, but if you don't understand it really deeply, you make some mistakes. Usually, I'll give them this simple rule: start to wrote the thing, and look at your code. If you are writing for a simple task too many code, you are getting the wrong direction. I think that this is. A good rule with Agile Toolkit to guess if you are choosing the correct path to implement the thing or not.
My last question here on training is how if you're taking a new developer into your team and start training him, do you require him to know certain things about development? How much experience are you looking as a minimum for the new developer?
Well, at the moment. At the moment, we had the senior and also the people that are really junior, that are at their first experience in working into a company. So for the different kind of guys, we use different approach to what we expect from them and what we teach to them and what we let do to them. This is, I think, normal in big environments. A guy that arrives here usually for the first 2 or 3 days don't do absolutely nothing of concrete, because he had to set up all the accounts, had to meet many different people from human resources, from the IT division, from direct boss. So it's quite stunning at the beginning, I think. So it's hard to have a standard path. But usually we let people decompress with all this information, and then we start teaching them the basic of the framework and also of the of our architecture. And after that, we start by giving them some tasks that are appropriate to their level and their knowledge of programming and of PHP and of Agile Toolkit itself.
Yeah, maybe a quick question. Do you think a better training program would be useful for maybe some sort
a
of
training program from Agile,
from
you,
Agile,
from
yeah,
your side?
Yeah.
Well, maybe, probably yes, because I remember my first day with Agile Toolkit, so I. As you remember too, because we contacted quite a lot at the beginning. I think that well, the documentation now is a lot better than the 1 year ago. So this is good. Probably a training program that get some of the material that it's in video and also some. Tutorials could be arranged, but I think that the material it's quite enough at the moment. Maybe organizing a part of it in a training course could be good to have a path through everything. Because, for example, at the beginning we thought to use some of the videos for our introduction to the framework. But they were all too long, considering the time that we have to illustrate the framework and also our project. Something about 10, 15 minutes could be great for this, but every video is 25 minutes or more, so it's too big to use it in an introduction with really with 10 or 8 people.
Okay, before I give it back to Armin and so he can get on track, I'm just chatting here with Gaurav, who has his own development house. If I remember correctly, that was India, right? And he have 30 plus people, and they doing a transitioning to Agile Toolkit. And he also says they are making a complete training course for Agile Toolkit in PHP. Plus, Gaurav is also contributing to Joomla community, and he's working on integration between Joomla and Agile Toolkit. And this is only the first one. Once that is ironed out, there are going to be many other integrations with other CMS systems. Wouldn't it be awesome to have a framework like Agile Toolkit for WordPress, Drupal, and so on and so on? So that was my note. Bob is asking, are you using a GitHub as a versioning control system? And if not, how you manage that, you have Agile Toolkit and Git, and the rest is, I think you have...
Well, at the moment, internally, we were using SVN as version control system. And for our internal processes of the development passing through from the staging to the production is made through the version control system. So we are using SVN. Of course, I'm using Git by fetching the various version or the trunk or the branch or tags of the Agile Toolkit, but we don't switch the framework so often for stability purposes, because we have a live product that hasn't to grow. Yeah.
Sure. I have a question about how you structure your code. Do you use the ability of add-ons in Agile Toolkit in your development?
But we are using some of the add-ons of the toolkit, But actually, in our plans, we aren't developing specific add-ons for our project. We are building the main application classes. Maybe for the part that we want to share with the community, we can package them as add-ons. But this depends also from the direction that Romans wants to give us by the part in such part that we can give back to the community.
Romans, maybe
the
you want
add-ons
to.
Idea is good.
Yeah,
it's really good.
You said that the thing is, Marco started with Agile Toolkit before when it was still compatible with 5.2 PHP, and we didn't use namespaces back then. So he transitioned to the current version of the Agile Toolkit. I think they're using 4.2 now, but most of the code is not using namespaces, and I don't see why they should use namespaces. Namespaces, when it's easy to convert any class into namespace, practically just a couple of lines of code, and then share it. But they can do it when they're ready. And I think, guys, you should share once you think the add-on is good and it can help others in any way as you can. For example, if you don't have time to convert and test, that's fine. Someone from the community will pick it up, will do it for you. And it's good that there is at least something. You can probably start a new repository on GitHub where you simply post all your add-ons, and you can contribute by adding more. And people will suggest and will push some changes to you.
Yeah, yes, surely. I think that the main part of the code that we wrote at the moment is our internal models or our application, that I think it's, of course, isn't shared as is, but some of the infrastructure part that we want to give back to the community probably will be packaged as add-ons. So we will start to publish them. We are discussing with you, you know. So
yeah.
I think that the next week we will start to put something outside.
Very excited about that. And one other thing we had in discussion, by the way, was about model table caching. So we have really nice models which talk with the database, and everyone love it because it's so easy to use. But we also want to introduce transparent caching in there, such as maybe Memcache or Redis or some other system. And we're working on that small project together with Marco, and once it's ready, it's going to be the part of Agile Toolkit.
Yep. I'll show you a complex schema so you can understand why for us it's important. It's can you see it?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So as you can see here, the global architecture of AppSuite is quite complex. It's a three-tiered thing. See, we have mainly involved three clusters of servers, the front-end one, the back office, and the database. Then we have also other related services that are around. And one of the thing that we need when by thinking how the service could scale on a big audience is the caching that we have in our internal framework that at the moment is used in the front-end part, the part that is on the right on the schema. And we need to use it initially in the part that it's is the API for the API for the developers. Because when the service starts to have a huge traffic, it's mandatory to decouple the database access from the access of the users. So I proposed to Romans to work on this stuff because we have started to work it on it internally, but I want to produce something that could be generic and used by anyone. So we are doing the first test in these days. It's an early prototype that we had made by patching the classes, and then I talked to Roman on how we could integrate it, and so I'm waiting for the details. We started to discuss on it on Google Grab, so everybody can also share ideas or requests or what are others need, for example, for a caching system that can be good for everyone.
Okay. So from the complexity of the schema that we just saw, I would assume that, of course, you already have loads of existing code in PHP and maybe some other languages. How do you integrate it with Agile Toolkit, like using APIs?
Well, luckily for AppsFuel, our that was a new project. The integration was initially a big issue because the part where the old frameworks and legacy code are applied are separated well from the new one. As you have seen in our in the schema that I presented, we have a complete separation between the different parts of the code and also of the logic,
yeah.
The business logic, the database, and the front end handling, and every part talk with the other by HTTP or something similar protocols that let you access the other part like an API. So for us, the only point in the integration was how we can, from the back office to the front end, send the information to in a good way for the front end. So we started by simply breaking the normal flow that Agile Toolkit have by initializing stuff and then rendering all the stack of the tree of the object that were created, and instead of rendering, break everything with an exit and the output in JSON of the result. After doing that, we started to think a little bit on this API approach. I've seen also in Google Grab some discussion about how to do a JSON output or an XML output of the Agile Toolkit application. So we formalized a little bit better this part, and now we are almost ready to show this part to the community, because it's quite independent from our application. We have three or five classes that are useful if you want to have an API output of your data, that also manage to have a live documentation of the API if you access it by your web browser. And I think it's quite a cool thing to implement. I can show you a thing on my browser.
Okay.
Okay.
Sure, yeah.
Okay. This is a call like the front end can make to the back office to obtain some data. As you can see, it's a URL called with a method. Okay?
Okay.
You can see it. And this is the result in JSON. If I simply instead of calling it as HTML, I call it as doc. I obtain this, that is the, you can recognize something, yeah? This is the runtime documentation of the same API.
Okay, nice.
And it's automatically made because the Stratus that handle the API, yeah, is using the constraint definition that it handle in input and outputs to print this document. So the constraints are always real because it's the same API Stratus, okay, they use to validate inputs.
Looks very good.
Of course, you the template could be better. This is the default one because now we don't have worked on the presentation now. But I think it's. It's an interesting idea and that we have implemented with not so much efforts by simply understanding the rendering phase and the creation phase and by inserting a small component inside. So I think that could be elaborated better, even to include different needs. Our next implementation that we have to do is to also print out the kind of errors because we worked a lot also on how the error is explained to the other Stratus, so to the user of the API, and so the autodoc for the errors and also the authentication. Because now this API is used internally between two servers behind the firewall, but the same component we want to use it with the API that is exposed to the final users. So we have to implement the authentication layer.
Okay, very impressive, huh? So what will be, because you were talking already about the next things you plan to do, what are the next tasks you need to implement with Agile? Maybe caching, performance?
Well, the next things that we are implementing in our project is to continue to implement the developer panel that, of AppsFuel that is that is the real parts that developer will use to interact with all the services. And this part is really, really complex, and this is our next next goal for our project. For the part that we then can share with the community, as I said, is the caching, because we will need them when we scale up, and we want to improve these APIs, APIs Stratus. We also have a couple of minor suggestion on some classes of the toolkit for applying in enterprise environment. One for them is the logger. I patched it to have some more configuration parameters to handle it in such a situation when you are not the root of the server that that is running your application, or if there are many different parts of your application that are running on the same server and you need to better organize the logs to understand what if you are, if your app is working well or you have some problems.
One other thing we are interested is a file store integration with Amazon or some other CDN framework. So how are you doing that? Maybe just your experiences and some code later.
Yeah. Yes, we can talk about it. We are We use Akamai. That is a CDN, and we use it for the static content and also for some of the PHP-generated content. They offer two kind of CDN services. So we have a quite big experience about it on some of our other products. So when you need it, we can arrange a meeting and discuss it deeply.
Talking about scalability, how are your feelings about how is Agile Toolkit performing on like scaling, consistency, and probably very important for you, security and stability?
Well, for the scaling, I think that we have done at the moment some benchmarks because, of course, AppsFuel, that it's a young project, doesn't have at the moment so huge loads as our other products. We have planned when we want it with millions of users, but we don't have now millions of users. But we stressed it a little bit, and we have done some tests. And at the moment, it seems that Agile Toolkit performed quite well in stressing the database really. We don't have so much stress on the database. The query optimization seems to work in our tests. So we are quite confident that could scale. Of course, if we want to scale over certain numbers, we need the caching, and we are working on it. About the security, I think that the correct behaviors that the toolkit impose or suggest to you, if followed correctly, gives also a quite good security level. For the stability, at the moment, I haven't seen errors that were in the framework. I simply got bugs for our code or small bugs that we reported by using classes, but in really complex cases. I don't know what you mean exactly for
Well, let's
stability.
say if you update to from 4.0 to 4.1 and then and so forth, you update the version of Agile Toolkit. Do you have any problems with upgrades? Is there any breaking in the code?
A small one. With upgrade at the moment, we are using two versions that are the 4.2 Git pre-release and the 4.2 fix after the release. Because our two checkout that I made from Git. Because we was one of the first adopters of 4.2 version before it was released to public, and mainly we are using those. I'm continuously updating the toolkit on the development server. We have a way to switch the distribution with a simple command. And surely in the next weeks we will switch everything to the last version. But because we want to, we are finishing to build the unit testing for every part of the project. So we want to switch everything when we have the unit testing ready to be sure that everything works fine.
Okay, since you mentioned unit testing, we do have a very lightweight tester class for Agile Toolkit. Are you just using that, or did you integrate for with unit tests, or are you build something on your own?
We are working on two different strategies. One that we have made, and when will share surely when it's completed is to integrate PHP doc test with Agile Toolkit framework. This is a good thing if you have core classes to test, because you've wrote inside the comment of the class or inside the comment of the of each method a sample on how to use the method and the test in the same thing, and this is really good for classes that can be tested can be tested alone. Yeah.
Okay.
And this is a good thing that we want to share with others. On the other part, we have started to try to implement the unit test with the class that you provide in the 4.2. We don't have enough material to give good feedback. When we finish to maintain all those unit testing with it, surely we will have or some contribution or some suggestion about it. We have also a third layer of testing that we already made. Is that because the unit tests are not ready now? That are automatic tests, but these are interface tests. We have you know a robot framework and things like that. These are it's a Google tool that lets you automate your browser. You've wrote in a meta language inside an HTML5 your test, and then when you start it, your computer start to click on the browser, typing and so, and checking if the application is working.
What's called Selenium?
Selenium and Robot Framework,
okay.
Yes.
Okay, good.
These are the two pieces. This is Google stuff, it's public. Our internal quality assurance team use them on computer and also on mobile devices to test all of our application. So we need to float them initially because were needed for all the process of quality assurance of products.
Okay, we already touched a little bit the topic of modules, and if you develop modules for Agile Toolkit and maybe sharing them, but I think we already, like you said, as of course it's your business logic, and probably you don't want to share that with others. That's pretty clear.
Yeah.
In case there would be like more general modules that you develop or add-ons that could be used by others that have nothing to do with your business logic, would you be willing to share them with the community?
Why not?
What does your boss say about that?
It's not a problem. It's part of the goal of AppsFuel. We want to be a thing that a tool for the developers. Surely we will share some parts that on the JavaScript side, it's not directly involving Agile Toolkit, but we as company we have done it in the past with other projects, and I think that if we it's also a benefit for our bosses if we continue to be committed with Agile Toolkit and we continue as now we are doing in using it excessively in a product and in other project. Maybe we are many I haven't seen before, but when we have done the training session, the last training session about Agile Toolkit, even other even people from other project, from other staff were inside the class to look at this new technology. So we think that it's a good thing for us to share things with the community, because yes, we are a huge company, but each group of that develop a product it's a normal development group. So by having the point of view of other people when you have a part that is not that solves a general problem, it's good also for you, because you can find bugs that you haven't seen, or you can insert ideas that you haven't, you don't have, and also you can have other people that introduce functionality that you can need. So it's a benefit for both. So from this point of view, bosses have a goodwill about sharing the non-business related part to us.
Marco, do you think you might develop an interface for Agile Toolkit to develop mobile applications?
Good question.
People are asking me. They're asking.
I think that this could be an interesting idea.
jQuery Mobile is out because, there. People asking, you know, you're using jQuery.
But I think that I can talk about with the experience that we got here inside, because before AppsFuel was born from an idea of giving out to third party the capability that we have internally in developing our web applications. Surely having a mobile version of Agile Toolkit, or a way to plug in something that lets you develop the mobile version of the application, could be good. For certain kind of application would be really a very useful solution for the powerfulness and strong point that Agile Toolkit have. I don't know if simply integrating jQuery Mobile is the best solution. It depends on how you model your web application, because if it's mainly server drone, it could be an easy solution. But if you want to reach a really good performance, you need something lighter. Nice. This is the thing that we experienced here inside when we started to give to people a 2.0 experience on a smartphone compared to the old experience of entertaining services on all devices. Many of us tried jQuery Mobile as a quick solution to convert a server-side generated site for the mobile. But later, when you start to design the application in a more mobile way, it's not so useful. You have too much constraint with jQuery Mobile. It's quite heavy.
Yeah.
So if you have legacy phones or small Android terminal, it's a little bit heavy.
Yeah, I had same feeling, and then I switched to SensorTouch.
So, but about the JavaScript part, I think that I'm not ready to speak about it now. But in a couple of months, we'll have some public talk about it.
Okay, good.
I can't say anymore.
Okay.
Maybe
like Steve Jobs.
It could be. Yes. maybe it could be some of our of work could be ideas for Agile Toolkit. Why not? Surely we will talk about it. If you have an idea of making some things that work on mobile integrated on Agile Toolkit, I'm here to talk with you.
Okay.
Maybe we meet again in person, or here in Italy, or in London, wherever you want.
Yeah.
Okay. I have a final question, and probably the question Romans is mostly interested in. Would you suggest other companies to give Agile Toolkit a try?
Yes. Yes, I would suggest it. I had suggested it to to some of my friends that have their companies and develop software on web. I think that for a medium or small company, it's surely a really good tool that needs attention, because it saves you a lot of work in building certain kind of modern application. On a big company, big environment, where it's harder to push new technology, I think that people need to look at it if they are working on PHP, and then find a way to convince their boss to give a try.
Well, Marco, thank you very much for joining us today. It was a pleasure to hear about your experiences with the Agile Toolkit, and it's great to see that a rather not so well-known framework made it into a big enterprise, and I think the people enjoyed how you approached to get in touch with Agile framework, and about your input when you talked to Romans about things to be improved. Was nice to have you here, and thank you very much for that. And thank you, Roman.